So good evening to all. In this class we see operations, research, and this is for 12th business maths chapter 10. Here it is given transportation problem. Main objectives of this is to determine the amount to be transported from each origin, that means beginning, to each destination, that is ending, terminal, such that the total transportation cost is minimized. So how to minimize the transportation cost is the topic in this exercise and exam exams we want to see. And see the tabular form. Here it is given rows from the 1, 2, 3, etc. n. Then columns 1, 2, 3, etc. n. So rows denoted by M and columns denoted by N. X11, X12, X13, etc. X1N. First row, nth column, last one. That denotes the quantity, of supply. And Cij denote the cost of transportation from one place to another place, that is from I to J. Here it is given demand and supply. What we demand and what to supply. So when the demand and the supply are equal, we are ready to do the problem. So the main objective is, once again I say, the total transportation cost to be minimized. So this is the main objective. Now we see one example sum from the book. So actually the problem is so easy, but the steps, we are reducing the cell, but I do in the same, we are considering all the columns and row together and do the problem. But in the book, it is given in the reduced form. One by one it is given. But actually I asked other teachers, they told in the same manner we can do what we are going to do now, so that you can get the full mark for that. Before that, first you have to check the supply and demand should be equal, then only the problem is ready to continue. The supply total is 34 and demand, this 34, here also it is equal to 34. So supply and demand should be equal, so that the given problem is balanced transportation problem. So you are writing, if the supply and total are equal, you are writing it is balanced transportation problem. So you are ready to do the sum. Here a destination and this is origin. This is row, all these row, four rows we have, and three columns. A, B, C refers to columns. Then this method is known as northwest corner method, NWC, northwest corner method. Means every time you are considering this cell, you are considering northwest corner cell only you are considering. The cell you are referring it as 1A, means the cell name is 1A. Second cell 1, B, this is 1, B and 1, C, then 2, A, 2, B, like that. Then each cell is referred in that way. And here you no need to write this step every time. Just we are allocating. Allocating means distributing. We are giving we are giving the duties to others, like that. Allocate as much as possible in this cell 1A, so that either the capacity of the first row is exhausted or the destination requirement of the first column is exhausted. First you are seeing, first you consider the northwest corner 1A. Here you see the supply and demand, supply 5, demand 7. Which is the minimum? 5 is the minimum. So in the cell 1, A, consider the minimum of 5, 7. This I repeat, here no need to write. this is only 5 mark question. This minimum of 5, 7, this is equal to 5. So you consider the minimum of 5 and 7 in using northwest corner method. This is northwest corner, first cell you are considering. So the minimum is 5. So immediately you take and write 5 here. You are writing 5 here. You are writing the minimum of 5 and 7. And separate immediately this 5. 5 minus 5 0. So instead of that you write in this way. So this is time consuming. The same 5 you separate here also. So 7 minus 5 2. And immediately you strike out this. No need to consider it. You are considering only 2 in the next step. So when you when it becomes 0, the row, the full row will be cancelled. You are considering the minimum, then subtract so that it is 0. So that you are cancelling the full row. Then next you consider, so this part over. You should not consider this first row, you leave it. Now the new one is, this is the new one. So we have reduced the table in the 3 rows and 3 columns way. Again you consider the northwest corner. Northwest corner means this only. So here 8 and cell, you in the using the cell 2, A. You are considering the cell 2, A. In this you find the minimum of 2, A. 8 and 2. So minimum of 8 and 2. This is equal to 2. So now you separate. Then 2 minus 2, 0. So immediately take and write the minimum first. First write the minimum, then you continue. Here 8 minus 2, 6. Then next one. Again you are proceeding in that way. If it is 0 means this column should be avoided. So you strike out the column. So this column should be deleted. Then using the pencil you just strike out. Now the new table is reduced in this way. Here you are getting the new table. Then next again you are using northwest corner. So you are considering this corner. Now you see here 6. So you are considering 2, B cell. Here the cell is 2, B. Now consider the minimum of this 6, 8 you strike out, 6 and 9, isn't it? This is northwest corner. Northwest corner, so that you are considering the minimum of 6, 9. So what is the minimum? 6. So immediately you take and write the minimum value. Now you separate this minimum value here. So 6 minus 6, 0. So immediately you strike out this. Then here 9 minus 6. 9 minus 6, 3. Then this you strike out. Now the since it is 0, you strike out the full row. If it is column means you are considering the, you are striking the column. Row means you strike out the row. Now the table is reduced to here. So in this way it is reduced. Again you are considering northwest column. This is the northwest column. Now you consider minimum of 7, 3. So minimum of 7, 3 is 3. So immediately you take and write the minimum value here. Now subtract this 3 here. So remainder is 0. Now subtract 7, 3. So this is 4. 7 minus 3, 4. Since it is 0, you just strike out this column. And the remaining is, it is reduced to eustachycote, this also eustachycote. Now, this is the possible reduced box. Now, you consider again the northwest column, this 7 you are considering. Then you have 4, minimum of what? Minimum of this 4 and 18. 4 and 18. This is equal to 4. So, subtract. First, before that, you write the minimum value first. Subtract 4 minus 4, 0. Then here 18 minus 4 means remaining 4. Now this is 0. Since it is 0, you strike out the row. If the column is 0, you are striking the column row. If the row is 0, you are striking the row. Then the last one is 2. That's all. Here 14, minimum is the same only. So 0, here also 0. 14 minus 14, 0. So take and write immediately the minimum value. So all the minimum value write within bracket. Now we are ready to find the cost and the way it is traveling. So the transportation schedule starts from the cell, which one? 1, A, isn't it? So 1, A, then you see, first see the first row, 1, A, that's all in first row. Then second row, 2, A, so 2, A, 2, A, then here 6, so 2, B, so 2, B. So second row over, now come to the third row. Third row, 3, column is B. Now third row, column is C. Now come to the fourth row. Fourth row, what is the column? Here C. So this schedule over, now come to the cost, total cost we want to find. Here the total cost means, this is actually, I told you, this is S, I, J, and this is C, I, J. This refers to C, I, J. C for cost, X for quantity. So usually if you want to find the total cost means, this quantity into this cost, this quantity into this cost, this quantity into this cost. So in this way you proceed and find the total. That means quantity into cost. So Xij into Cij. Actually this is Xij into Cij. So 5 into 2, then plus second row, 2 into 3, then plus second row, 6 into 3, then plus third row, 3 into 4, then third row, plus 4 into 7. Now come to the fourth row, 14 into 2, so plus 14 into 2, so 10, 6, 18, 12, 28, the answer is 102, book answer 102, yes it is correct, so the answer is correct. So this is simple problem. The tabular column will be given. You can write one by one. You can reduce. You can write the reduced tabular form. and proceed the problem. Otherwise, you can do in the same tabular column. Thus, you are considering whichever is small. You separate. If it is 0, means you are striking the row. Here, if the column is 0, means you are striking the column. Consider the remaining table and proceed in this way.